published 21:03 Eastern Daylight Saving Time, the 19th of July 2018, updated 21:03 Eastern Daylight Saving Time, the 19th of July 2018 live, Paul Simon Hyde Park, London, a stirring swan song rating, live board Thomas O'Meara, London, encouraging return rating, as farewell go, this was long and fond. Having announced in February that he was retiring from touring after 6 decades on the road, Paul Simon stirred the emotions as he played his last ever show on British soil. Bringing to a close this year's cycle of British summertime concerts, the American singer-songwriter, who stands 5'3", cut a diminutive figure as he shuffled on stage in Hyde Park. Once he started singing, though, we were clearly in the presence of a musical giant. As farewell go, this was long and fond. Having announced in February that he was retiring from touring after 6 decades on the road, Paul Simon stirred the emotions as he played his last ever show on British soil. Simon, 76, delivered more than a perfunctory run-through of his greatest hits. There were lots of familiar big hitters, of course, even though Mrs. Robinson and I'm a Rock were surprisingly overlooked. But there were also some intriguing deeper cuts, plus new arrangements of well-loved tunes. Even on his victory lap, he still gently nudged the boundaries. As he opened a sprawling, 150-minute set with America, the Simon Garfunkel song about hitchhiking that gave the Michigan city of Saginaw a footnote in pop history, the video screens behind him were blanched out by the evening sun, giving the show a traditional, low-tech feel. "I'm waiting for the sun to go down so I can take my sunglasses off," quipped Simon. There followed a whistle-stop tour of global music. "An accordion heavy that was your mother looked to Louisiana's Zydeco. The obvious child" featured Brazilian samba drums. The cool river was enlivened by a manic, jazzy solo from pianist Mick Rossi, and "Mother and Child Reunion" remains one of the greatest white reggae singles ever made. Performing with greater warmth than on previous tours, Simon told the stories behind some of his songs, "The Wonderful Renee" and "Georgette Magritte with Her Dog." "After the War" was written in Joan Baez's house after he found a book about the Belgian painter. The number imagines René and his wife are secret fans of 50s doo-wop groups such as the Penguins. He was accompanied on that song by New York chamber ensemble iMusic, an exceptional tet of string, brass and woodwind players. iMusic's classical stylings are more suited to the concert hall than the open air, but their flair and precision still hushed a huge crowd, despite a few murmurs about the lack of volume. A new take on "Bridge Over Troubled Water" was less striking. Simon explained that he wanted to wrest the song back from his estranged former bandmate Art Garfunkel, "as this is the last tour, I'm going to reclaim it like a lost child," he said. He lacks Garfunkel's vaulting vocal range, however, and his subdued new arrangement was a rare misstep. The latter part of the show was celebratory. It began with excerpts from Graceland, the landmark 1986 album that combined African rhythms with Western pop. There's an understated power to this deceptively low-key third album from Australian duo Luluk. Songwriter Zoe Randall's lilting voice is a thing of beauty, while multi-instrumentalist Steve Hassett's subtle adornments add shade to the melancholy Cambridge and shuffling title track. Randall recalls her fraught teenage experiences on the small-town anthem "Me and Jasper," while guitarist Aaron Dessner, of American rock band The National, makes a guest appearance, rating "Diamonds on the soles of her shoes" segued into "You Can Call Me Al," with Bakithi Kumalo flawlessly recreating his famous bass solo on the latter. But it was the second of two lengthy encores that will live longest in the memory. "Homeward Bound," composed on the platform of Widnes Railway Station, was heartwarming, while some of the most haunting lines in the box are I am leaving, but the fighter still remains and the sound of silence." "Hello Darkness," "My Old Friend," took on new meaning as the sun set on this show, and Simon's brilliant touring career on these shores. He's now back in America, where he will finish the Homeward Bound tour at Flushing Meadows in New York on September the 22nd. He's also releasing a new studio album, In the Blue Light, which will revamp 10 of his favorite solo songs. Never One Merely to Slip Slide Away, He's bringing the curtain down in style, and twin sisters Catherine and Lizzie Ward Thomas became the first homegrown country act to top the UK album charts 2 years ago, when they were second offering Cartwheels, went to number one. The Hampshire siblings, aged 24, are now preparing for an October follow-up, Restless Minds, and they previewed 6 new songs at an intimate club show in London. Dating right back to 1983, the Now series of compilation albums has proved remarkably resilient, surviving a succession of sea changes in the music industry. Unsurprisingly, then, this 100th edition sticks to a familiar, hits-driven formula. Opening with Calvin Harris and Dua Lipa, it also contains big summer singles from George Ezra and Clean Bandit, leaning heavily on chart pop and dance. The Spice Girls, Oasis and Bon Jovi feature on a bonus disc of hits from the now-not-so-recent past, rating, if Cartwheels added pop trimmings to their country roots, Restless Minds looks set to bring even greater depth and variety. Taking the duo in more of a country soul direction, It's Not Just Me was one of several new numbers that address the difference between the picture-perfect life and hard reality. Lie Like Me explored similar themes, while No Filter was a powerful rocker in the tradition of female duo heart. But the pair's peerless harmonies, showcased on this too will pass and a cover of the Years single Shine, remain central to their appeal, with dark-haired Catherine's soft vocals complemented by Lizzie's piercing pop tones. No longer gauche newcomers, they are looking ahead with elegant assurance. Paul Simon's new album, In the Blue Light, is out on September 7th. Ward Thomas start a UK tour at the Tartan Heart Festival, Inverness, on August 2nd. WardThomasMusic.com.